They used to say when I was a kid, though, you could no more do that than go to the moon. Well, we went to the moon. I grew up essentially as an only child because my older sister died before I was born. And so I had a lot of attention from my parents. We were not wealthy, but there was a lot of love in my family from my parents, and it was a good life. The first model airplane I built, I remember, this is embarrassing, but I put the wings on backwards. And the reason was that it seemed to me the sharp edge should go first, like in a knife, so it would cut through the air. But of course, on real wings, the sharp edge is on the back, the trailing edge. And I like to say I was ahead of my time. For hypersonic flight, you do want the sharp edge forward. I actually studied geological engineering my first year in college, and then I met a fellow from my high school who was at Princeton studying aeronautical engineering, and he said that's what I ought to be studying. And so the following Monday, I switched my major to aeronautical engineering. My first week in graduate school in aeronautical engineering, they launched Sputnik. I didn't know what a Sputnik was, but I soon found out. I applied for a job in the aviation industry. I thought I wanted to work on airplanes, and by mistake, the personnel department, for whatever reason, put me in the Missiles and Space Division, which I was fascinated by. I've encountered my share of challenges, just as everybody does in their career. Clearly, the biggest one there was when the Berlin Wall fell and the defense budget also collapsed. It was a great event for the world and for America in particular. But for the aerospace industry, it was a disaster. And I had just become CEO of Martin Marietta, and it was not an opportune time. But we had a great team of people, we had great outside advisors, and were able to work with other companies that were in a similar boat and built what I think of as being a great company today that's being run by some great people today. I worked on the Nike Zeus and the Skybolt missile, and I worked a little bit on the Apollo program. Of course, I was involved in the F-16, the F-22, the F-35, and was involved in a number of spacecraft, none of which we can talk about, but all of which were significant to the country, I think. People have looked at the sky for thousands and thousands of years and puzzled about them and wondered what was there and could you go there. When Neil stepped down, I turned to my son and gonna say this was something that you'll never forget, and he wasn't there. And so I went scrambling around to find him, and he was under the bathroom sink looking at the pipes, studying the pipes. So it was a great effort, but anyway, my wife and I thought it was a pretty big deal. My wife is an amazing woman. She has unbounded courage and determination. We've spent our lives together, and I can't imagine it being any other way. We've been to the North Pole once and the South Pole three times, and I discovered there was no East Pole or West Pole, so I settled for Timbuktu. But the ultimate would be, obviously, to go to the moon or to Mars. If we have any sense of immortality at all, it has to be through our children. That's the thing we leave. You can leave buildings and things, they disappear with time. And we've had two fine children, and they happen to be fairly accomplished, but putting that aside, they're decent people. That's what you ask. Being a grandfather is probably the best job in life. One of the things I've enjoyed the most, I might say, is taking the kids on little ventures around the city. And the Air and Space Museum is one of our favorites. I was born just right into the aeronautics age and at the beginning of the space age. And not only that, through a series of accidents, wound up actually as a participant in aeronautics and space. I think of my father and mother, they knew people who crossed the prairies in a covered wagon, and they met friends of mine who walked on the moon. When I look back on my life, I sort of say, gee, who is that person that did that? I never could have imagined. I'm sure that were I a forest ranger of the mountains of Colorado today, I'd be as happy as a clam, but I would hate to have missed all that's gone by. if we turn our back on space and exploring the cosmos, I think it would be a tragic error. And on the other hand, if we do it, to do it successfully, which we can, it'll be more of the great accomplishments of humankind.